that you're here with us this morning. All month long, we've been talking about turning things upside down with humility. So before we jump into the service, I have a very fun game for y'all to play. We've played it before. It's Spot the Difference. So are you ready? Let's play. You guys. So before we enter into the word, let's go into worship. I love to worship. So are you ready to worship? Psalms 28:7 says, "The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him and helps me, and my heart leaps for joy, and with my song I praise him." So let's do that right now as we sing.
Has fallen when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided.
humility. What is humility? Humility is putting others first by giving up what you think that you deserve. Humility is kind of upside down from the way things usually go. It's like living in that opposite world. Usually we tend to think me first instead of you first, right? But humility flips that all around. Humility means that we find a way to put others first instead of just thinking of ourselves. Jesus gave the greatest example of humility. He lived his life in a way that seemed opposite of what people would expect. He is the all-powerful Son of God, but he came to serve. He died on a cross so that we can have a relationship with God that lasts forever. Jesus lived out of humility, and with God's help, we can do that too. So last Sunday was Easter, and we celebrate the fact that Jesus came to be our Savior. He died on the cross for our sins, and he came back to life. Jesus' life, death, and resurrection changed the way everything works, including the way that we see others and the way that we treat them. The Apostle Paul explained it in the letter that we call the Book of Philippians. Paul was writing to the people in the town of Philippi who were the followers of Jesus. Listen to what Paul wrote. Philippians 2, 3, and 5 through 8 says, "Don't do anything only to get ahead. Instead, be humble. Value others more than yourselves. As you deal with one another, you should think and act as Jesus did." Jesus was equal to God, but Jesus didn't take advantage of the fact. Instead, he made himself nothing. He did this by taking on the nature of a servant. He appeared as a man, he was humble, and obeyed God completely. He did this even though it led to his death. So let's watch today's story.
Hey everybody, I'm Jake. I'm really sorry if I look or sound funny today. My shirt's really tight, and I'm afraid if I breathe out, I'll pop a button. I gotta breathe! Today, I'm gonna talk to you about humility. Humility is putting others first by giving up what you think you deserve. One of the ways I like to put others first. So you're probably thinking that the smart thing to do would be to change shirts. Well, I already tried that, but none of my shirts fit today, or any of my clothes. At first I thought maybe I had gained a little weight. I mean, I have been eating a lot of mustard-filled donuts lately, but even my shoes don't fit, and I don't think I gained any weight in my feet. Almost got it, almost. Or my head. I don't know what's happening right now. Wait a second. I bet one of my friends is playing another April Fool's Month surprise on me. They switched all my clothes with smaller versions of my clothes. Man, that's elaborate. I gotta do something now. That's the rules of April Fool's Month. Somebody does something to me, I've gotta do something back. Something big. Something that's never been done before. I'll put a bucket of confetti over the door. So whoever walks through will get a bucket of confetti all over them.
Yeah, Jake, you're a genius.
Nope.
Easy boy.
So, today's story is about how we should treat people like they're more important than we are. I can't wait to try that after I prove to everyone that I'm the best at April Fool's Month surprises. Yeah. How many buttons does this thing have?
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. And now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Philippians, chapter 2, verses 3 through 8.
Jesus' life and death and resurrection changed the way everything works. It changed how we view others and how we treat them. One of Jesus' followers, a man named Paul, wrote about it in a letter to believers in Philippi. "Don't do anything only to get ahead. Instead, be humble. Value others more than yourselves. As you deal with one another, you should think and act as Jesus did. Jesus was equal with God, but Jesus didn't take advantage of that fact. Instead, he made himself nothing. He did this by taking on the nature of a servant. He appeared as a man. He was humble and obeyed God completely. He did this even though it led to his death. Let's imagine how this truth might play out today. Angus McCrane had been up since 5:30 a.m. for his job as a school bus driver. After three morning routes, he skipped lunch to clean out throw up and a spilled soda from the back of his bus.
Yuck.
Then there were three afternoon routes and a whole stack of paperwork waiting for him at the bus garage at the end of the day. So by the time Angus got home, he was starving. He couldn't wait to dig into this delicious ribeye he'd picked up.
Gonna fire up that grill right away.
While the grill heated, Angus prepared a baked potato and sauteed green beans.
A little salt, a little lemon. Doo-doo-doo.
Then he seared the steak to perfection and slid it on his plate alongside the fluffy baked potato and crisp green beans. Ooh.
Ah, thank you, Lord Jesus, for this food. Amen.
Angus sliced off a corner of the sizzling steak and skewered it with his fork.
Ah.
But before he could take a bite,
oh, for goodness sake.
With a regretful glance at his steak, Angus headed over to his front door and opened it. His new chipper neighbor Marge stood there, holding an enormous Siamese cat.
Hello, Marge.
I am so sorry to barge in, but I just found out about a super last-minute work trip, and I don't have anyone to watch Boris while I'm gone.
Angus just stared at the cat, and the cat stared back, smugly, as if he knew Angus hated cats.
Well, I gotta tell you, I've never been around cats much.
Oh, that's no problem. I've got everything you need right here.
Angus looked past Marge to see several bags and boxes, plus an entire carpeted climbing tree.
So, could you do it?
Angus glanced sadly at his quickly cooling steak, but he could see Marge was a little desperate.
Well, okay.
It took Marge nearly 10 minutes to explain every little detail of Boris the cat's care. Finally, Angus was alone again with his steak. And Boris.
Yeah, better keep those fuzzy paws away from my dinner, you hear me?
But before Angus could take a bite!
Ah, what on earth?
Angus jumped up and hurried over to the side window. He could see exactly what had happened.
Ah, that boy.
Zachary Kircher was a kid who lived next door. He loved sports, but didn't have good aim. He'd already dented Angus's car with a baseball and destroyed a patch of petunias playing soccer. And this time, it was a rogue football that had hit the window.
Huh. At least it didn't break the glass.
Angus saw Zachary scrambling to recover the football and make his escape, but as he tried to hop the fence, he stumbled.
Serves him right.
When Zachary got up, Angus could clearly see that he'd badly gashed his knee. Angus sighed, thought mournfully about his steak, and opened the window.
Zachary!
Sorry, Mr. McCrane, I'm leaving.
No, just hold on a minute. We gotta clean up that knee.
So Angus grabbed his handy-dandy first aid kit and headed outside. It took another 10 minutes to clean out all the dirt from Zachary's scrape and get it all bandaged up. And finally, Angus sat down to dinner again for the third time. His steak was barely warm.
I am so hungry I could eat the entire cow.
But before he could take a bite.
Oh, that don't sound good.
Angus ran to the front window. It appeared that the neighborhood ice cream truck had swerved to avoid Zachary, who had ran into the road to chase his football. Big no-no. And now that truck was listing sideways on a flat tire.
You have got to be kidding me.
Angus opened the front door and headed down the sidewalk. The poor teenage driver was checking out the damage.
It's my first day on the job. I wrecked the truck. They'll fire me.
No. It's just a flat, son. You wait right here.
With a deep sigh, Angus headed back to his garage, grabbed his handy-dandy toolkit, and showed the young driver how to remove the flat tire and replace it with a spare.
Thanks. I'd totally give you an ice cream sandwich, but they might fire me for giving stuff away.
Angus wiped the grease off his hands as he watched the ice cream truck ramble down the street. Speaking of ice, his dinner must be stone cold by now.
Excuse me?
Angus jumped a mile to see Marge standing behind him. She was wearing oven mitts and holding a hot apple pie. Steam seeped from the cracks.
I can't eat this since I've got to leave. I thought you might like it.
Well, glory be.
Angus inhaled the heavenly smell.
First I interrupt your dinner, then you help that kid next door, and now changing a flat, you sure put others first.
I don't generally feel like doing it, but thank you.
Angus happily accepted the apple pie. This time he would be putting dessert first while his dinner reheated in the oven. Now, it would have been a lot easier for Angus to just eat dinner and ignore the people around him who needed help. But little by little, God was helping him serve others, just like Jesus did.
Okay, so the bucket of confetti is set. As soon as someone walks through the door, the bucket will fall and they'll get covered in confetti. But let me think for a second, because something doesn't quite fit right. I'm supposed to think and act like Jesus did when he was here. Well, how did he think and act? Jesus is like God's only son, but instead of staying in some big heavenly castle, he came here as a baby and then grew up serving people, helping people who are sick, teaching people who wanted to learn. Then he died for us and came back to life. So, how did Jesus think? He thought that people mattered a whole lot. And how did he act? He loved and served and gave up everything for people. Gave up what he deserved for me. And you know the rules. Somebody does something for me, I've got to do something back. So I took the confetti myself so no one else would have to. I mean, it's not even a big deal. I like confetti. And these aren't even my clothes. Sometimes putting others first gets a little messy. But you know what? That's okay. You don't put others first because it's easy. You should put others first because that's what Jesus did for you. That's the one thing I learned today. Put others first because Jesus put you first. I'm gonna say that over and over again so I'll remember. Put others first, cause Jesus put you first. Put others first, cause Jesus put you first. Love others, cause Jesus loved others. Like your family, your friends, your brothers, your sisters, your mother, your gardener. Put others first, cause Jesus put you first. Man, I feel like brand new. It's like putting on a fresh pair of clothes, except clothes that actually fit. Ugh. I'm gonna need to change. I am getting confetti in my lungs. See you next time.
So wrapping up today's story, God created a perfect world, but unfortunately, Adam and Eve disobeyed him. They chose to sin, and we have all sinned. And sin breaks our relationship with God. It separates us from him. But God had a plan to save us. That meant Jesus had to give up everything to come to this earth and save us. And that's exactly what he did. After Jesus' death and resurrection, people talked about what he did, and he was full of humility. This is what people remembered about Jesus, how he gave up everything for us. As we live our lives and interact with the people around us, we need to remember what Jesus did. That will encourage us to do the same for others as we choose to put them first. Remember this, is our bottom line for today. Put others first because Jesus put you first. So let's pray. Dear God, we thank you so much that Jesus showed us what it looked like to live with humility. He put us first and chose us, and we want to follow in your plan. Please help us to follow your example, the way to treat people this week. We know we need your help to do that. Please give us the strength to put others first, just as Jesus put us first. We love you, and we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. We're so glad that you joined us today. Kids, remember that we are having a raffle all month long to win a huge big prize filled with candy. So what you have to do to win that prize is memorize your scripture verses and do your Bible devotions. You can find those online. Your parents can download them for you at our church website. Also, we'll be texting them links to find those. So don't forget to do those. We're so excited to see who wins. God bless you. We love you. We miss you. Have a great rest of y'all's day.